Hello and welcome to the Holiday 2022 Aquarium Update. I must apologize. Like many holiday flights, this video was delayed after it became apparent that I needed a new laptop. Such is life. In this episode, we open up the curtain in my daughter's room for a few minutes and get some cool footage of the pencil fish tank in the sunlight. We go crazy for shrimp in the 210 and show how we use the cold Minnesota air to ventilate the fish room. We pick up some plants from my local aquarium club and start soaking a gigantic log in the 210-gallon aquarium. Thank you for watching and enjoy!
Live blackworms. Feeding live food is one of the best things you can do for your fish, I think.
Even though they're absolutely disgusting.
All right, we're gonna feed these guys some blackworms. Look at those catfishes go. They are excited.
The discus tank, this is my favorite tank to feed blackworms to.
That's excitement.
So you can feed blackworms to pencilfish even. It's kind of fun to watch them slurp them down like a piece of spaghetti.
Speaking of pencilfish, let's check out some beautiful footage of them hanging out in the sunshine.
The colors you get when fish are lit with sunshine are amazing.
Bright blue ventral fins.
Bright red anal fin. And the red and the caudal fin. Absolutely stunning fish.
Now here's that same fish under normal lighting.
Natural lighting, natural sunlight. Look at that, folks. It is so pretty to see this planted 29-gallon pencil fish tank in the sunlight. There's a one-line pencil fish hanging out. See how those Equus pencil fish utilize that Amazon sword to hide from me? Smart little fish. We have some gold tetras just trying to peek out into the sunshine. There they are. Oh, there's a red Beckford's pencil fish as well. We've got a catfish, Panacores, in the sun. There he is. Look at that natural sunlight, Calico Pleco from Tamed Waters. Thank you guys. Beautiful. I got three of them in here, I think. Oh, there comes a coolie loach. See, they're very... You see them, and then they're gone. Banana plant in the sunlight.
All the little details are pretty in the sun.
Our plant scrubber is doing good here. Put some of the floating plants from the 65-gallon into this tank. And yeah, I mean, that really has helped improve the water quality and decrease how frequently I have to do water changes. Gold tetras in the sunlight look amazing. They're like golden silver tip tetras. They're so pretty in the sun.
Look at that male red Beckford's pencil fish. Great shot of all the little pencil fish.
Set up a red pencil fish. Male and female set up a red. I have not been able to get them to breed yet. I just love the way the plants hang down there. Oh man, it's so pretty. Anyway, now we'll close these shades because of the algae.
And our pothos plant up here is pretty awesome.
This is helping to improve the water quality big time.
Let's head down to the fish room to see what holiday surprises await us there. Okay, so he didn't make it into the fish room, but he was right there.
Here's the 210-gallon Leprinus headstander geophagus tank. Love this tank.
And we're gonna feed these guys some shrimp. Once it's partially thawed, I stick it on the cutting board and chop it up that way.
I don't care what happens, the sky can fall and omelets can go over all over the stove. I'm gonna learn. I shall overcome.
I like to chop mine pretty small so that all of the animals can enjoy some shrimp. It's what's for dinner. These guys are gonna go crazy for the shrimp. Here we go. that's impressive. The guy ate that big chunk. Going fast. So the big fish obviously like it. When they're hungry and excited to see me, this is what they do. Man, these Chelseas, I think they always think I'm gonna kill them. I'm not going to kill you. So these guys like to jump out of the water, so you gotta have a nice tight lid. We built a canopy. Female geophagus. There's nothing more striking than a group of headstanders eating together. Aquarium fish hieroglyphics. We got the smoke on the water.
I use the cold Minnesota air to ventilate my fish room.
You can see the windows propped open here with this algae scrubber. I use various devices to keep this open a little further, or when it's cold like today, below zero, we keep it just propped a little bit.
Can I feel?
That's weird, you can't really feel it. But you can see the vapor evaporate.
I can
when feel it's that cold, that's how much water is actually evaporating into the air.
My tank is actually losing a lot of water.
Yeah, exactly.
Since we know more about water vapor now, let's head over and see what's going on in the 65-gallon aquarium.
With pandemic restrictions finally lifting, I have been able to access my local club, the Minnesota Aquarium Society. I have met such wonderful people and would recommend that you check out your local club if you have one, as they may be loaded with amazing people and useful knowledge.
Well, we got a couple new plants from the plant extravaganza from the Minnesota Aquarium Society. We just had a meeting the other day. And what a cool event that was. I had so many plants that I've never seen before, right before my eyes. And shameless Aquarium Society plug.
Well, hey Francis, a couple weeks later, this Cryptocorn spiralis is doing pretty good. Got some new leaves there, some new shoots. We'll take it. The wisteria is doing good back here. And our Eleocharis vivipara hair grass is doing pretty good. It's listed as like a tall plant, so we'll have to see if it grows tall or not.
Well, I'm here from the future to tell you it does not grow. The kissing gourami ate it while I was on vacation for a few weeks. But you live and you learn. At least I got to stop by one of my favorite fish stores in Seattle, Washington while I was visiting.
Got the banana plants. Grips. You can see this one's got some nice new growth on it.
All right, let's come on in here and check out the 150-gallon discus tank.
Yep. We have our clown loaches lounging around underneath the logs there, the Yule log. Yep, very popular place. Fish are eating zucchini.
I had this guy in my son's aquarium about 4 years ago.
Still there. There's a special lady friend.
She's not my special lady.
Yeah, I love this tank. It's a Marineland 150-gallon high tank. They don't make them anymore. I think it's an amazing tank. I love this tank. These guys here, these flag cichlids, they love chewing up the jungle veil here in their little territory. So we got like one side of the tank is plant heavy, the other side not so much. And then of course we got our cardinals in the background.
The flagtail Procolotus. He's a good boy. He's a big fish. Spotted silver dollars are doing good. And then we'll take a look at some of his discus.
This little guy, this is the feistiest discus we have. Always picking on the bigger ones. Here's a little guy. And of course we got our candles up top. There are these pillar candles, and they work very nice. And they're made in the USA. Got the kid art wall, it's filling in nicely. At our next update, I'm gonna have to tell you the tale of this log, which is currently soaking over here in our 210-gallon Leprinus tank. I'm getting out all the tannins from this log because I love the way the tannins look in this tank. And eventually, once most of the tannins or some of the tannins are out, I'm gonna stick it over there in the discus tank. It's gonna be sticking out of the discus tank kind of in back there. And so we'll have to reconfigure our top piece here. But I think it's gonna look really quite cool. You guys excited?
Creo que ese tronco me hará parecer más una piranha.
All right, so here's the thing I did. If you kind of look in between those rocks there, there's a tiger lotus bulb that's starting to sprout. These clown loaches were using it as a soccer ball, like they're going for the World Cup. And it was just getting kicked around this big tank by him, and I was like, how can I anchor this down? You can see about a month later, this plant is doing pretty good. They're getting bigger. Well, thank you guys so very much for watching. In addition to explaining this log, we'll tell you what's going on down here with our new quarantine tank. Catch you next time.